Hello you guys, welcome back to my channel. My name's Janice if you're new here. So this video is going to be another shoe review. So on my channel I have lots of barefoot shoe reviews. I've been wearing them for probably 4 to 5 years now. I love them. I probably own around 10 pairs, so I feel like I can give a pretty good review in comparison. So the one I'm going to review today is the Fieldgrounds. This is a new release from them. This is called the Drop Top. So it is their first shoe that doesn't have any laces. It's just a slip-on. So when you look at it, you might not think it looks like a barefoot shoe, and that's the point of the company, to make stylish barefoot shoes that are healthy for your feet. In previous videos, I have reviewed their high-rise version, which I love, the original one, and now this is the third pair that I have from them. For reference, I'm a woman's size 9 US, which is equal to size 40, so this brand of shoes does fit true to size. And my foot is a little bit on the wider side. My left foot has a little bit of a bunion, probably from wearing too tight of shoes when I was younger and wearing high heels a lot, which you shouldn't do if you're younger than me. So that's why I do prefer barefoot shoes. Also, too, I've said in all my other videos, when your big toe is freely movable and you can plant it into the ground as you walk, it's a lot better for your hips. It activates your glutes. Your glutes will be on fire after a walk when you use shoes like these. Everyone should be wearing these if you can. Because I work in healthcare and wear scrubs to work, I'm lucky that I get to wear sneakers. So I was thinking this particular shoe would be great for me because during my breaks, I have to change into another pair of shoes before I leave the office. So I'm really looking for something that's quick that I can easily slide my foot into. I think this would be a great travel shoe. I was looking at them, and out of all the models, they can be packed really easily. You could squish them together and look. Like they barely take up any room in your bag. You could slide them in your carry-on. Even if you don't have that big of a purse, you could put them in that. Because I really like to travel, I was just thinking, like, even on the plane, sometimes after you've been traveling, your feet kind of swell, you've been doing lots of walking, these would be so comfy to wear. Also, for driving, I think they would be great. I don't have a car at the moment, but when I did used to drive, I would never want like a too bulky of heel. These have a zero drop, you can see. I think out of all the models, this one does. For whatever reason, I think it's because it doesn't have the laces. I find it fits maybe slightly wider because this is a little bit more open there, and I have a little bit more room at the back. So out of all the models, if your foot is very wide, I would suggest getting this one. This is going to be the most comfy. And definitely, I've said again, if you work in healthcare, say you work at a hospital, this would be great. If you have a job where you're doing a lot of steps per day and your feet are tired, sore, they swell, definitely invest in a barefoot shoe. If you're like me and you kind of had wide feet, you have bunions, any sort of foot pain, you know you will probably pay whatever it is to get yourself out of that pain. So I don't mind spending more money on barefoot shoes because I like to wear them the majority of the time. So the price of the shoe, it does fluctuate a little bit depending on what your dollar is at, what country you live in. So I'm going to link them in the down bar. I'll link all three of the models that I've reviewed and the other videos as well. I cannot say enough good things about this company. I can attest to during quarantine, almost every single day I've walked between, I try to aim for 10,000 steps, but some days we go over 20,000 steps, which is a lot of walking. My feet have never hurt at all. Just a little bonus tip for foot health, I would invest in a lacrosse ball. So even if you don't have foot pain, it's good to roll your feet out every night, especially though if you do have foot pain, you should be doing that nightly or daily. You can just do it while you're watching TV on your computer. And also, I really like the toe spacers. I have been able to wear the toe spacers with all the Fieldground shoes. So if you're wondering that, you can sleep with them on. So that's just great too. You should be able to easily get your fingers through all your toes. If you find it's very hard to do that, your toes are being compressed, you need to really loosen them up. Because some people ask me, I wanted to show you a comparison of just how wide the foot is. So in Vivo Barefoot and Fieldgrounds, I'm both a size 40, which is equal to a size 9 US. So you can see the length of these shoes is pretty much identical. Same when I put them side by side. So they both have a zero drop, but you can see when you look at it from the side, I mean, what would you rather wear to be stylish? Definitely this one. So here is for you people that were saying Vivo Barefoot seem to be more foot shaped or wider. These ones actually, you guys, are pretty much identical. And to be honest, the feel grounds are maybe a little bit wider. So I think you're wrong in saying that they're more foot shaped. I think it's due to the stitching and that they use different fabric. It kind of makes it look more like a foot. This doesn't. So, I mean, obviously these are two very different types of shoes. You probably wouldn't be wearing these for the same types of things. But if you're concerned that this isn't as wide or foot shaped, you're wrong. Definitely Field Grounds is. And to be honest, this is more comfy. This is my thinnest Vivo Barefoot one, but it's still definitely thicker. This one, I can definitely feel the ground more, hence the name. I wouldn't necessarily say one is better than the other. There are two very different shoes, but just in case maybe you've already owned a pair of these and were wondering how these stack up, the foot shape is very, very similar. And you would probably be the exact same size in both. And I always just like to show you guys what the shoes look like when I have my coat on, when I have my outfit on. I'm just running out to do a couple errands, go to the mailbox. So yeah, that's what they look like. They're super, super comfy. As always, I love all the shoes from this brand and they look great with jeans on as well. Again, you can easily move your toes around. You have lots of room to spread them out. It's very important that you can move your big toe freely. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions, like always, just leave it in the comments below. Bye.